After an amazing spectacle we got from Bleach Anime Episode 6, The Fire, being Yamamoto versus Yhwach, can Episode 7 pull up to the plate? Can it really reach those highs and those lows that we're going to get in the aftermath of this fight? Truthfully, the answer is probably no. But we got the spoiler images, so let's deep dive into them, talk about them a little bit, and see where we're going to go from here, because we may actually be pleasantly surprised. So, stick around. Throughout the video, you will be seeing some images of what's going to be going on within the show, so I do recommend you go check them out and digest them all in. But before all that, let's give you a brief synopsis of what it says on the website. Now again, translations are iffy because I'm not going to go out my way to translate it myself. Yhwach standing in front of Yamamoto, Gemryusai, Shikegune was a fake, as we all know from Roy Lloyd. Gemryusai is cut in half by the attack of the true Yhwach that eventually appears. Shunsui Kyoraku and Jushiro Ukitake, who sensed the situation, were horrified. Yhwach talks about how the 13 court guards and Gemryusai have changed. If you haven't seen my video recently on the reaction of the original 13 court guard squads, one, I recommend you go do so, and two, they do look a bit more menacing than the ones that we currently have at the moment, if I'm honest. So yeah, maybe Yhwach was spitting there. The Soul Society is thoroughly overrun by the Sturmritters, and the Serate is destroyed and crumbling. In the midst of a situation full of despair, tremendous spiritual pressure rises above the Serate. Dun dun dun, who could that be? I think we're about to find out through these screenshots, to be quite honest with you. Now in saying this, we should have some good lows and some good highs. If they can do Ichigo's rage and frustration come out, then that will be my peak for me. That's my expectation of what I really want, like some high, you know, quality animation in terms of like emotion, voice acting, and just overall display of energy, where I do want some really good somber moments, especially within the reaction of the Soul Society with Gemryusai Yamamoto. We are going to be getting some backstory as well, maybe, because in the manga, and as I said in the 13 Court Guard Squad's video that I made the other day, we do have a little bit of a flashback, whether it will be silhouetted or whether it will be coloured and animated. That would be interesting and new. It's even a possibility considering who's on the staff listing, which I'll talk about as well. But my expectations going into this is that Episode 7 kind of needs to pull up just a little bit, you know, because I feel like you can't have Episode 6 and then go straight to a dead episode. You kind of need to continue off, like conclude it a little bit. Even though Episode 6 did conclude, you kind of need to follow through with what happened after that episode. And then if you want to go dead after that, which to be fair, an episode after this one, in my mind, considering where I'm guessing it's going to end, it should be the majority of talking and setting. So I'm not going to have too much expectation for Episode 8 personally, maybe even Episode 9, but we'll come to see how those plays off. But I'm expecting at least a good chunk of this episode to be, you know, still pretty gas. And to be honest, looking at the staff list, I'm pretty, you know, excited to see where we're going to go, because even though that this isn't a Taguchi storyboard, we still got some great people on this. And to be fair, some of them that I learned today, I don't really talk about staff that much because I have such a fear of just like messing up and really kind of disrespecting, you know, some of the names and just not being overall well educated. So as time goes on, I'm probably going to be more educated or talk about more of their experiences. But for now, you're just going to have to bear with the bare minimum. It's a learning curve. We get through it. Shout outs, Cindy is back on this episode. Cindy is great at everything she does. So of course, whenever I see Cindy on one of these staff listings, I do get excited. She's amazing. Hiramitsu is in the screenplay, so you know that if Hiramitsu is on the episode, there is going to be, to some degree, some extra content, which again, I'm excited for, because we don't really know where the extra content's going to come from. There is a screenshot here. One of our first screenshots is going to be of Shunsui Kyoraku as a kid, so I'm guessing we're going to either get the flashback of his interaction with Gemryusai Yamamoto, we could even get it of the original 13 Court Guard Squads. We don't really know. There's many possibilities, but it seems to me we're going to get at least some level of original content. What that original content's going to be, we'll have to find out. Now, if you're a fan of Yamashita and the work that they did on Episode 6, well, I was made aware today by Anime Blue, shoutouts to you, that Toshiyuki Tsuru is a guy that is working on the storyboards and is actually a really big deal. Now, I know, you know, some of the Naruto openings, I'm quite a fan of a lot of them, but, you know, you don't really know who works on them until you really go and look. And, you know, most of these Naruto openings that they have worked on have been amazing. And so it was really interesting to come to find out that Toshiyoshi actually is, I guess you could say, his sensei, his tutor, inspiration, whatever kind of terminology you want to use. So I'm very excited to see that as well, because this is my first time kind of acknowledging or knowing of Suru to really be excited for. So I'm not really quite sure what to expect, and that's an exciting thing nonetheless. The point I'm trying to make is that overall, the team is genuinely strong for an episode which I genuinely didn't expect it to be. But enough chit chat, we already got into one of the screenshots being Shunsui Kyoraku. Look at him, little rascal, young Kyoraku from how many years ago? Way over 100, that's a fact. 200, 300, who knows? But it's always good to see that, because most of the episode, I imagine, is going to be very grey. So it's nice to have a different contrast every now and then, because, you know, seeing grey can be a bit dull, can be a bit, you know, boring on the eyes. So I'm very excited to see a little bit of the past, a little bit of maybe extra content in regards to, you know, Yamamoto and, you know, Kyoraku seeing the image on the wall, and maybe a glimpse of other things that we just didn't see. I'm just excited for that. There was a bit of screen time in regards to the manga with this scene. So next one we have is a nice blue-grey shot of Yuha Bar. Again, nothing really special to say here. We've seen Yuha many a times. I know that they're not trying to spoil, but I imagine by the look on Yuha, I imagine, you know, he's not too pleased that maybe Ichigo's come on the scene. That's my guess. First half of the episode, isn't it? So that's what I imagine is the reaction here. But we've all seen Yuha's face. They didn't really want to give us anything here, did they? So take what we can get. Again, we have an amazing shot here of Jushiro Uketake probably reacting to what happened with Yamamoto. Though, in saying that, in regards to looking back on the Yuha picture, that's probably the scene that I'm guessing is where he tells, like, Yamamoto he's a disappointment, and that, like, his past self was a lot better and not as naive and not as prideful in terms of, like, getting the job done. Maybe, I'm not quite sure, but I imagine that that's the part where he's probably stepping on his head. We'll see if I'm right. The shot here of Uketake looking shocked here is a great shot for many reasons. One, because, yeah, we did get a glimpse of the rain and of how the effects are going to be looking, you know, last episode, in episode 6, and it seems we're going to get a lot more of that being displayed in this episode. So again, it's always going to be a nice visual spectacle treat to see just the amazing effects. That's really going to accelerate just how bad this situation is, and just see how clothes are going to work and how they're going to look and how they're going to kind of weigh down on the characters' hair, what the water itself kind of like, you know, because water in Akudama Drive looked absolutely beautiful. So I'm excited to see just how it's going to, you know, bring alive these scenes. Because again, we have everything but the rain, which is going to be something that's going to be happening in this arc, and that is going to be very symbolic. So whatever we get in these scenes is going to be like a little taste or a teaser of what we're going to be expecting visually down the line. Harshwold is Harshwold looking, to some women, beautiful as ever. I haven't seen the appeal of hash browns myself. But there's your man's. He's there, you know, looking how he looks. And I imagine that this is, I wanna say the execution of Big Yama. That's what I wanna say. That's my guess. Unless this is a reaction shot of Yuha scolding Yamamoto. Though I imagine it's probably an Ichigo shot as well, because the next shot that we do get is a beautiful shot of Ichigo Kurosaki, blood on the face, looking tired out. And of course, I left this one to last because, again, I talked about that rain, and look at Ichigo's hair. It's been weighed down. There's volume there. Ichigo's worn out. I wanted to say something in the review that I didn't as well in like episode 5, I believe, is that something in the manga that was never included and is a consistent attention to detail is, if you notice in this screenshot and if you notice in episode 5, the Tenza Zangetsu sword is chipped. This is the first time we've seen an Ichigo Kurosaki sword chip, besides from when Hiyori obviously did her bits in the Visored arc at the start of Wake on Mundo. So, you know, when we were talking about how the Getsuga Tensho was turning from black to white, these symbolisms, these foreshadowings are showing more and more apparent, and actually builds up to what we're going to be getting with Ichigo within this episode. So you actually have to give praises to the anime in this portion that it is accelerating the hints, the foreshadowings, and also the immersion into the little details. And I do gotta give, you know, a lot of praise to Taguchi for that. I'm a little bit disappointed in this image in particular though, because there's not really any like wrinkles of rain within the Shihakusho part. But you know, the fact that Ichigo is tired and he's got the blood, you know, I really want to see what he went through in that jail, because obviously it seems he was hurting himself, or maybe he was self-harming, you know, unintentionally while trying to get out of that jail. But this is going to be a powerful scene, and I can tell from the staff that again are working on this episode is that, you know, they do a lot of Naruto and Sasuke stuff, they do a lot of those sad scenes, so I'm very excited to see how they're going to pull this off. I can't wait to hear some Sagutsu music, because I know this Ichigo scene is really going to be impactful, and that's where my expectation is that give me just the high quality moments when it needs to be, and save it all for the Ichigo parts, because I feel like that's where it's going to emotionally hit people the most. And also, like, this is probably the most Ichigo's ever looked in comparison to his manga shot, so that's also nice as well. Maybe it's just me, but like, I saw this screenshot and I was like, damn, that's actually pretty manga-esque, to be fair. That's like pretty on point. But yeah, I've been waffling on for too much. Tell me your guys' thoughts, of course, in the comment section down below, of what you're going to be expecting from this episode, and if you are hyped. Bit of a silly question, because I know you are going to be hyped, but, you know, like and subscribe, all that good stuff. I will see you for the next video. You guys, of course, have this fine day being Hanson. Peace out.